Well-known child star and Disney actor Tommy Kirk passed away a few days ago, September 28th, I believe. Cause of death at this time has not been announced. He was 79 years old. I think most of us remember Tommy from the classic movie Old Yeller. My goodness, he was so darn wonderful in that movie. Even though I absolutely hated the ending of that film, I loved his work in it. Anyone who has seen that movie knows that Tommy was able to see more with his facial expressions than with any of the lines that were actually in the script. Although Old Yeller is my first memory of Tommy Kirk in film, he had actually been acting for a couple of years before that movie. Later on, when the old versions of the Mickey Mouse Club played in reruns during the late 70s, I would discover that he'd been cast as Joe Hardy in an adaptation of the Hardy Boys that would occasionally show up on that program. And after the Hardy Boys and Old Yeller, Tommy starred in another Disney classic, The Shaggy Dog. By this time, it must have been clear that Tommy was very much a huge part of Disney's future. A year later, he would star in Disney's adaptation of the classic novel Swiss Family Robinson. And a year after that, he would co-star with Fred McMurray in The Absent-Minded Professor, and then its sequel, Son of Flubber. Around this time, Tommy was very much an actor in demand. I think it's absolutely fair to categorize him as a Disney teen idol. Just like Annette Funicello, who co-starred with him in 1964's The Misadventures of Merlin Jones. Now, I'm not going to mention every movie or TV show that Tommy was in, because during the early 60s, there were a lot. The man was definitely an actor in demand. In fact, at one point, Walt Disney himself, while visiting with Hedda Hopper one day, ran into Tommy and greeted the young man with a ton of enthusiasm and referred to him as his lucky charm. It really seemed like Tommy had it all figured out. However, Tommy was hiding something. Something that he knew would threaten his career. You see, Tommy was gay, and while he did his best to hide it, it wasn't long before word got out. And well, let's just say the offers kind of dried up after a while. In 1965, Tommy would make his last appearance in a Disney movie, a follow-up to The Misadventures of Merlin Jones called The Monkey's Uncle. After that, it kind of felt like Tommy was on his own. The offers didn't stop immediately. In fact, before the release of The Monkey's Uncle, Tommy had reteamed with Annette in a non-Disney flick called Pajama Party. And if you look at IMDb, you can see that Tommy did find work during the mid to late 60s. It was in the 70s that the offers really just kind of stopped. I remember seeing him in an episode of The Streets of San Francisco. Man, I really loved those Quinn Martin TV shows. I have got to think that the 70s had to be a really trying time for Tommy. His life, just a few years earlier, had been so hectic, and then, just like that, the fame just went away. At this point, when he was acting, he went by the less recognizable name of Thomas Kirk. At some point, Tommy made the decision to leave Hollywood and take up residence in Las Vegas. I don't know this for sure, but I've got to believe the change of scenery was good for him. Even if it was Vegas, getting away from Hollywood and everything that came along with it had to be something of a relief. Although he would take a movie or TV role every once in a while, the 80s and 90s were mostly spent outside of the limelight. In 2006, Tommy received word that Disney wanted to honor him with a Disney Legend Award and recognize him for his contributions to the success of the Walt Disney Company. Throughout his life, Tommy had taken a tremendous amount of pride in his entertainment career, but his Disney films were definitely the thing that he took the most pride in. So as you can imagine, this award, well, it meant everything to him. Flash forward to present day, and Tommy's death was announced by fellow child star and longtime friend Paul Peterson, who said, "He was very much a part of our kid star community. He made some wonderful films back in the day. We saw and enjoyed them. He was respected in his church. He lived a quiet but full life." Now it's your turn, folks. Please share your memories of Tommy in the comments section, and while you're at it, I'd love a thumbs up if you found this video interesting, and I would be honored if you would consider subscribing to my channel. I talk about music, movies, and mostly television from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.